Spotlight Theater founder.
Hi everyone, I'm Spotlight Theater's co-founder Thompson Schmoltz, and we are so excited to have you all here to see the amazing work of our fantastic cast. They worked so hard over these past few months, and they are so proud to present to you this amazing show that they've put together.
We'd also like to introduce our staff and lovely team, our senior directors Cam and Ian, assistant directors Alan, Raya, and Flannery, our technicians Jiwoo and Louisa. Special shout out to Louisa for doing both sound and lights today due to some COVID-related illnesses in our staff. And our set builder and designer Isaac, and our prop master Joanne.
We'd also like to give a special shout out to Griffin Schroeder, who will be recording both of our shows. Speaking of recording the shows, please put all cell phones on silent. And please refrain from taking any photos and videos during the show. We know it's very tempting when you see your kid on stage to want to snap some photos of them, but those phone noises and camera screens floating above the crowd are very distracting, not only to our actors, but also to the rest of the audience. And as you can see from all of our cameras and our microphones, we will be recording the show, and those will be available through email and through our website shortly after the performances. So we will get you those photos and videos. Do not worry.
And speaking of our website, you can access both the website and the Lorax Playbill on your tickets that we handed to you right as you came in. All you need to do is scan the QR code with your camera app or with your phone, and it should take you right to the link for both.
And last but certainly not least, please make sure you keep your mask on at all times when you're in the building for the safety of our cast and your fellow audience members. The cast will be wearing masks on stage as well. And just like our actors, we ask that you follow all our safety guidelines. And to also follow CDC guidelines, there will be no intermission or concessions. But if you need to use the bathroom, they are right down the hall that way. And we ask that you just quietly exit if you need to use them. Preferably don't do that during the last scene of the show because we will be using the aisles at that time.
And now without further ado, we present to you all the Lorax. Everybody, and thanks for coming tonight. I am the Lorax, and I speak for the trees. I'd like to say a few words, if you please, regarding the story that you're about to see. It actually happened. Just take it from me. But there's more to the story than what's on the page. So please, pay attention while I set the stage. We open in Fleetville, a city, they say, that was plastic and fake. And they liked it that way. A town without nature, not one living tree. What happened to them? Stick around and you'll see.
How much sugar?
Hey, Dad.
Hey, Si, could I put in a double order for next week?
Of course, you're signing here.
Seems like I'm going through air faster than ever these days.
Tell me about it. I guess it's just a smoggy year.
Isn't every year?
Oh, Myrtle, you're too funny.
Hi, Charlie, delivery for you.
Oh, yeah, I've been waiting for this all week.
Enjoy.
Is my air here, Si?
You know it.
Thanks a bunch.
Whoa, is that the new bad techno tree?
Yes, I love it. It uses 96 batteries and the laser mint scented. Wow, mint scented. I want one.
Looky here, everybody. Mayor Meyer's making an announcement.
Excuse me, coming through. Official Kneadville Arlene News business coming through.
Greetings, good people of Kneadville.
Greetings to you too.
Move over, please. I need to get a good angle for the viewers at home.
Mr. Mayor, what's the announcement?
Well, as your mayor, I'm pleased to announce that today we have a reason to celebrate.
Woo!
In Fleetville, we love living the way we do. It's a more than perfect paradise, and it's about to get even more perfect.
How could it get more perfect than this?
And even bigger, even better, O'Hare Air Factory is being opened by our very own Fleetville national hero, Aloysius O'Hare.
Hooray!
Now there'll be even more air for us all to buy.
Look, Mom, it's Mr. O'Hare.
Oh, wait, hi, Sam.
Hey, kiddo.
Look over here. It's Mr. O'Hare.
Make sure to get my good side.
O'Hare, you are here.
I love you, Mr. O'Hare.
And I love you, Thneedville.
Mr. O'Hare, give any comments on your new factory.
Bye, O'Hare Air.
O'Hare Purified Air Camp, a breath of fresh air. Straight from the bottle.
O'Hare.
Why, thank you.
When I was younger, it was my dream to one day be a zillionaire. Now through selling air to all of you here at Needville, that dream has come true. So thanks to all of you for making my dreams come true.
What would we do without you?
Breaking news fed at Needville Hourly News. O'Hare Air stock soared to record high.
I love O'Hare Air.
There's no air better than O'Hare's.
Accidentally crash your remote helicopter onto his roof.
But what if he knows we did it on purpose?
How would he know? Just be cool.
Channel your inner Suave.
Oh, hey Tessa.
Hi Adrian.
Did your ball land in my backyard again?
What? No. It was a helicopter this time. It's on your roof.
Huh. I'm not sure to get it down from there. It looks pretty stuck. My dad probably wouldn't want us climbing up that high. Do you mind waiting?
Yes, I'd love to. I mean, totally don't mind waiting, whatever.
Well, while you're here, can I show you something cool?
What is it?
Come on, I'll show you.
Whoa, did you paint this?
Do you like it?
Are you kidding? It's amazing. What are they?
They're trees. Real trees. They used to grow everywhere before they all got cut down. They're beautiful. And nothing like our plastic techno trees.
Wow.
So let's say,
hypothetically,
if someone somehow found a real living tree.
I mean, they'd have to be the most amazing person ever to live. I'd do anything to see one. I bet that sounds crazy. Does that sound crazy?
No, not crazy. Not crazy at all.
Summer, autumn, winter, and disco.
Look at me, Mom.
Come on, Tessa, dance with us.
Yeah, Tessa, please.
Mom, stop. Mom, you are embarrassing me. Mom, stop. Mom. How am I embarrassing you? We're all family here.
Mom. You're so boring.
Okay, okay.
So, anyway, let's just find a tree. Where would I go? What would I do?
You need to find the Wunsler.
Whoa,
what's a Wunsler?
Mom, it's really not the time for one of your magic fables, okay?
That's right, I forgot.
I must have just imagined that real trees used to exist in my elderly delusions. I'm old and can't even remember to put my teeth in.
Come on, Mom, that's not what I meant.
No, I really forgot my teeth. Will you be a deer and go get them for me?
Yes, Mom.
I'll come with you.
Okay, kid, here's the deal. You want a tree? You need to find the Onceler.
The Onceler?
Mm-hmm.
Where can I find him?
Far outside of town, where the grass never grows, and the wind smells slow and sour when it blows, and no birds ever sing, except for old crows. That's the place where the Onceler lives.
Wait, outside of town?
That's right. They used to say that if you brought him 15 cents, a nail, and the shell of a great-great-grandfather's nail, he would tell you everything.
This. Can we go home?
No.
We have to find the Onceler.
Tessa, don't you think you're taking this thing for Adrian a little too far? I get that you like him and all, but...
It's not just about him.
Wait, but I thought that's why we came out here, so, you know, you could find him a real tree.
Yes, but when I saw his painting, I can't explain it. There's just something about real trees that's just magical.
What do you think the Onceler will be like?
How do we even know he exists? We've been walking for hours and I've seen no cars, no stores, just these stumps and this junk in our Thmeadville power lines.
Hey, what's that?
Unless what?
Who are you? Who are you and what are you doing here?
Hello. My name's Tessa.
I'm Kathy.
Olivia.
Are you the Onceler?
Didn't you read the signs? No one is supposed to come here. Get out of here and leave me alone.
Wait, people say that if someone brings you this stuff, you'll tell them about trees.
Trees?
Yeah, you know, real ones that, like, grow out of the ground.
Hello?
Sorry, it's just that, well, I didn't think anyone still cared about trees. Well, that's me, the girl who cares. I'm here.
So you want to know about trees? About what happened to them? Why they're all gone? It's because of me.
Wait, what?
It's because of me and my invention, the Thmead.
What's a Thmead?
It was an amazing product that could do the job of thousands.
That sounds ridiculous.
Why do you think your town is called Thmeadsville? That town used to love me and my Thmead.
Well, what went wrong?
It all started when I was a young boy leaving home.
But just remember, if somehow your invention ends up a failure instead of a success,
it won't surprise me at all.
Nice wheels.
Burn!
Yeah, burn, but you'll see. I can prove you all wrong.
So there I was, at my very bottom, with nothing but a completely irrational sense of optimism. I was searching the globe, obsessed with finding the perfect material for my need. But I had absolutely no success. Until one day, I found
I think he did it!
Liar!
leave. Vacate the premises. Take your axe and get out.
And who are you?
I am the Lorax, guardian of the forest, and I speak for the trees. So you're telling me you did not just see me magically appear out of the stump? With all the thunder, lightning, and everything? You didn't see any of that?
No, but I think I know what would make you a little less cranky. I've got one of these for the cutest little guy I've ever seen. Yummy, 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 yummy.
How dare you? I'm going to eat this, but I'm highly offended by it. The human has been here not only 2 seconds, and is already leaving his garbage everywhere? Get out of here!
What are you doing? Hey! What's that?
Bitch!
Stop that! What's your deal, man?
Happy to go, beanpole! Get out of here!
Okay, that's it. Some of us have work to do.
No!
All right, you know what? You listen to me, you fluffy meatloaf. I am going to chop down as many trees as I need. You got it? Newsflash, we're not going anywhere. End of story.
Then you leave me no choice. If you're not gone by the time the sun sets on this valley tomorrow morning, then all the forces of nature shall be unleashed upon you and cast you to the end of your days. You have been warned.
Thanks, yeah, okay.
You have been warned.
I didn't listen to his words, and you'll never believe what happened.
What?
If you want to hear the rest of the story, come back tomorrow.
Hey, wait, tomorrow? Are you serious? You live in the middle of nowhere.
It stinks out here. Don't make us come back. I guess you don't really want to hear the rest of the story then.
No, we do. We really do. It's just that
You don't have what it takes. Goodbye.
Wait. I have what it takes. We'll come back. It's no problem. See you tomorrow.
Mm-hmm. Maybe. Just maybe.
Really soon.
Honey, oh.
do you play this one again?
Mom, we've been over this 100 times.
Have we? Oh, I know this game. It's the one with the deck of cards, and every time you draw a 7, you get a bowling ball to knock down your opponent's battleship, and then you get a bingo. Am I right, or am I right?
Okay, that's it. Family time is over. It is now me time. I'll be in my room.
Okay, sweetie. Have fun! I knew I could break her. Go!
Huh?
The Onceler. Go see him.
Oh, yes. Thank you, Grammy. You rule.
Ready to go?
Bring it on.
Yes, I brought extra air this time.
Hello, Native Old Soldier.
Hi. Can I help you?
Maybe so.
Are you?
That's how we get.
Our boss would like to have a conversation with you.
Yes, sir. We found the kids. Over.
Who's your boss?
Well...
That would be me. Nice to meet you. Tessa. Right?
Mr. O'Hare? Nice to meet you, too.
So, I hear you've become interested in trees. What's that all about?
Where'd you hear that?
Tessa. There's not much that goes around here in Tunisia that I don't know about. Here's the deal. I make a living selling fresh air to people. Trees, they make it for free. So when I hear people talking about them, I consider it kind of a threat to my business.
Wait, trees make air for free?
We don't know what you're talking about. I've never even heard of
you. Listen to me, kid. Don't go poking around in stuff you don't understand, or I'll be your worst nightmare.
So my mom is expecting me, so...
Of course. Now go back to your family game time. Your sister just finished her turn. Grandma's up next.
How did you know?
Please, I have eyes everywhere. You've got a beautiful town here, kids. Lots of fun stuff to occupy your short attention span. Why, I can't think of any reason you would ever want to leave town again, okay? Ever. Good talk. Really good talk.
What are we gonna do now?
We keep going. But Mr. O'Hare, he's watching our families.
Yeah, I know. He's not some super villain. He's just another businessman like any other. And if what he said about the air is true...
And if we bring the trees back...
No one will buy O'Hare air anymore.
Exactly. Then he'll have no control over the town.
It makes a difference.
Hey, we're back.
What have you got there?
Marshmallows.
Yes, thank you. I knew you missed me.
Wait, what?
Well, you're back already. Clearly you missed me a little, right?
No, we didn't. We're just here to hear the rest of the story.
Oh, why are you so interested in trees anyways? Why aren't you like the other kids? TikTok dancing, Snapchat stories, whatever that word game is.
I just thought it would be kind
kind of cool to have one. You know? No particular reason, really.
It's for a crush, isn't it?
What? No.
Really? Because when a kid does something stupid once, well, it's because they're a kid. But when they do the same stupid thing twice, it's usually to impress some kind of crush.
Hey, he's not just some crush. He's an artist in 8th grade and he loves trees. So I'm gonna get him one.
Aw, that's so gross. The Lorax warned me that if I didn't leave, all the forces of nature would be unleashed upon me and curse me until the rest of my days.
Gonna wanna buy that thing.
Well, good to know, because fortunately you're not the target market, weirdo. See you later, when I'm a millionaire.
Well, good luck.
Gonna blow some minds, gonna solve some needs. Well, didn't sell on the first day, it's fine. Or the second day, also fine.
or the third day, or the fourth, or 50th. Less fine. My family was right. I'm done with this thing. I quit!
Here, have a free meet. Closing sale.
Hey, cool hat.
You're like a style icon.
That hat looks amazing on you.
Really?
That thing makes me like you more.
No, I totally want one.
Everyone want one?
I need one.
Yeah.
Yeah, come on, everyone. I get it.
Well, you did your best. What more can I do? Come on, take a seat. We'll be in.
Thank you. What are we playing?
Poker.
Wait, I thought we were playing Go Fish.
Okay.
I'll leave.
No, me.
Oh.
Do you hear that?
Hear what?
Oh my, that's a lot of people.
That was the first one of her. Tell me,
Which way does a tree fall?
Down.
A tree falls the way it leans. Be careful which way you lean.
All right, kids, get to work.
Wow, I mean, look at this. It's amazing. I am so proud of me.
Muncie, we've got us a little problem.
Problem?
Mm-hmm. See, we're not making things fast enough. Harvesting the tufts takes too long.
Well, what else can we do?
Well, and this just came to me. We could always start chopping down trees.
Chop down the trees? No, wait.
Now you're thinking that would speed things up.
But...
No buts, Lindsay. You're in the business now. You have to do what's best for the company and your mama.
Well, I guess it couldn't hurt to chop down a few trees. They'll grow back.
You made me so proud, Lindsay. Come here.
Hey, I love this guy.
Twist, Fizz, cut him down.
Here you go, kids. Have fun.
No, stop it. Please, stop.
Take this, you stupid tree.
Get chopped.
Check this out.
Cry to your mother?
Cry to Mother Nature.
You're a genius.
You're a genius.
Where do you think you're going?
Excuse me, I need to talk to your boss.
Oh, I'm sorry, but Mr. Wunstler's not seeing anyone at the moment.
Yeah, well, he'll see me, so.
Yeah, I don't think so, Peanut.
Hey, get your hands off me.
Give me a reason, Furball.
Hey, you broke your promise. You're better than this. You've got to stop. This is bad.
Have a nice day.
Bad? I'm not bad. I'm the good guy here. He just doesn't get it. I mean, something good finally happens to me, and he just has to come along and rain on my parade. What's his problem?
Well, there's
So, how are things?
What are you doing here?
Happy yet? You fill that hole deep down inside you? Or do you still want more?
Look, if you have a problem with what I'm doing, why don't you use your quote-unquote powers to stop me?
I told you, that's not how it works.
Oh, right, I forgot! You're a fraud! I need you to get out, now!
Why? Do I make you uncomfortable? Remind you of the man you used to be? The promises you've made?
You know what? You can shut your mustache. My conscience is clear. I have done nothing illegal. I have my rights, and I intend to keep chopping and chopping and turning more truffle trees into thieves. And nothing is going to stop me!
Well, that's it. The very last one. That may stop you. Sending them off. Hopefully, they'll be able to find a better place out there. Somewhere.
Bye.
Good luck with your next invention. Have fun destroying someone else's home.
Yeah, nice to know it.
Smelling star. It was my big empty factory, the Lorax and I. I'll never forget the grim look on his face when he hoisted himself up and flew through the hole and smoked. All the Lorax left behind was a pile of rocks with one word, unless.
Wow, so you were the only one left, all alone?
What about the animals?
I never saw any of them again. Hopefully they found a better place out there, somewhere.
Like where?
I don't know, there aren't many good places left.
So this is really all your fault. You destroyed everything.
Yes, and every day since the Lorax left, I've sat here thinking about what I've done, staring at the word unless and wondering what it could have meant. But now I'm thinking, well, maybe you three are the reason the Lorax left the word there.
Wait, us? Why would he leave that for us?
Because unless someone like you clears a whole awful lot, then nothing is gonna change. It won't. The last truffles. You need to plant it.
But nobody cares about trees anymore.
Then make them care. Plant the tree in the middle of town where everyone can see. It may seem small and insignificant, but it's not about what it is, it's about what it can become. This seed is not just a seed the way you are not just a kid.
We won't let you down.
I know, and I think I have a plan. But I'll need some help from you three. Let's just hope I still remember my hair and needs, though.
Thank you.
dig with. What do I have?
Tessa?
I'm busy, Mom.
That's what we need on Wiggins. Get down here.
Tessa, I would like you to meet Mr. O'Hare, the most powerful man in town.
There she is. Hello, Tessa.
Hi. Isn't she clever, Mr. O'Hare? She knows her own name and everything.
You know what I would love, Mrs. Wiggins? A delicious cookie.
You want me to get you a cookie now?
Wonderful. Thank you so much for offering.
Sure. Why don't you go ahead and adopt her? I'm just kidding. That was a joke. I'll get your cookie.
I know you have Tessa, so let's put an end to something, shall we?
Penny over.
Sorry. I don't know what you're talking about. Well, then I guess you wouldn't mind if we took a look around.
Wait, yes, I do mind.
Sick, Zach, find a seat.
Stop. You can't do that. Put that down.
Come in here.
No sign here. Where is it? Where is it? Tell me where it is.
What's going on? Tessa?
He doesn't involve you.
Go back to your mother.
Tessa? Avery?
Mrs. Wiggins, we were just conducting a small...
I do not care who you are, you crazy
baby man! Get out of my house now before I call the police! This is outrageous! Fine, sorry, must have been misunderstanding. We'll be leaving now. My apologies, Tessa, you be safe.
Mind telling me what's going on here?
Wait, the seat! Where is it?
What seat?
Right here! Hello? Tessa, what's going on?
Adrian!
So, what'd you call me over for?
It's about this.
Wait, is that?
Yes, the last truffle seed. And you're going to help me plant it right in the middle of town where everyone can see it.
I could just kiss you right now.
We really don't have time for that.
I don't know. We have a little time.
But you know what? Forget about it. Let's just go.
Hi there, my name's Sai, and I'm just an O'Hare delivery guy, and I think
these trees done all right. I say, let it grow.
I'm Corbin.
And I'm Lou.
We've lived in Sneedville all our lives.
We never knew how much trash we were dumping outside.
So with these trees, does it mean that our daughter Sam can grow up without breathing in all the smog?
Exactly.
Please, can we let it grow?
My name is Yertle, and why I don't think I've ever seen a tree before, I say, let it grow.
Yeah, let it grow.
Let it grow.
I'm Grandma Wiggins, and I'm old enough to remember when real trees were everywhere, and we didn't need to pay some greedy businessman for just some fresh air. I say, let it grow.
My name's Avery, and I'm 8. I guess trees seem kind of cool. I want to let it grow.
My name is Aloysius O'Hare, and really, guys, I'm one of you. I've lived in Athenville all my life, just like you. And maybe you're right. Maybe we should let it grow.
Really?
Nah, I say let it die. Let it die. Let it die. Who's with me?
Nobody!
Aloysius O'Hare, I hereby remove your title as Sneedville Town Hero.
What?
For good.
Get him!
Breaking news by the Sneedville Early News. O'Hare, once hometown hero, is being banished from Sneedville. Looks like he won't be a zillionaire for much longer. Better sell your O'Hare air stocks while they're still worth a cent.
As your mayor, I'd like to thank you kids for helping Sneedville turn over a new leaf, as it is. I'll leave you to it.
All right, let's do this.
Thank you, Tessa. Thank you all.
You've done good, people. You've done good. Come here. Oof! By the way, nice mustache.
Yeah. Truffula trees are what everyone needs. Plant new truffula, treat it with care, give it clean water, and feed it fresh air.
Grow a forest, protect it from the axes that hack. Then the Lorax and all of his friends may one day come back.
Thank you.
And from them and now, Kiki has always got such amazing energy to rehearsals. Just such a great presence for her castmates and for the show in general. And although we are very sad that we won't get to see you at VHS next year, we know that you're going to be amazing things in Europe. So.
Bye.